Like I said, this is Tate on Rumble. Let's see what he talk about, man. This is a new video of his.
The reason feminism is promoted, because it's a direct competitor to masculinity, right? The reason masculinity is directly attacked is very simple. Every single rebellion in history, every single revolution in history took place when men got pissed off and went to the streets. If you're the elites of the world, there's only a few of you and there's a lot of very pissed off men. You have to make sure men don't realize I'm working for fucking nothing. They forced me to put a mask on. They closed my business. They've taken my travel.
Crazy.
If you wanted to do something like Corona, you need to destroy masculinity, absolutely. Think how many...
Yo, bro. I said, bro, chat. He be talking, he be dropping jewels, man. How y'all feel about this, man? Put it in the comments. Let me know how y'all feel. Y'all don't be communicating. Y'all need to subscribe to the channel right away. Y'all be acting like whole cornballs out here. Feel me? But let me know how y'all feel about Tate.
How many politicians got blasted for less? I mean it. Like, I don't mean it in a bad way. I mean it. And just like, think how many bad things happened to whoever, rulers or whatever, for doing a lot far less in terms of restricted freedom than Corona. How do you do it? You remove masculinity, and you do that specifically by taking one man, putting there with one woman, making it basically impossible for him to leave. He's in the face of financial downfall or destruction, letting him sit there in a sexless marriage with kids who don't really respect him, paying taxes until he dies. You have to remove the warrior spirit from men to control society. If men still have warrior spirit, you can't control us on this. Everyone's gonna be like me, and we're all gonna say no. You don't want that. You don't want men to say no. So this is the reason it's done. It's all done very, very purposely. Don't think that, oh yeah, they're making me live. Society is trying to make me live a life I'm not happy with, and it's reducing my testosterone levels, and it's making me miserable. Why does it do that? It's all done absolutely and utterly on purpose. Absolutely and utterly purposeful. It's purposeful. And that's how they control us. Because it's the men who are going to stand up and say no to things. But we don't stand up and say no. You know why? Because the wife will be mad if we're out late. No rebellions. Got to be home at 9. That's what it is.
Whole sucker out here. I can't be, gotta be home at 9. No rebellion. Y'all heard that, chat? I hope that's not y'all, man. Your wife don't tell you what to do, man. You the king. You make the rules of the land.
Bro, you got an Instagram boyfriend behind you in frame. Why are we talking about this shit?
But this is the reality of it. I understand completely why, as a government, they've come along and said, look, one man, one woman, sit there, even though they know it's not biologically normal. There's a few reasons for it, right? So we've got the first reason. Let's talk about the one man, one woman thing, where it came from. Because everyone knows it's not biologically normal. The human biological norm is that the top men have all the women, and the lower men have no women. If you look at the history, if you actually look at the genes, something like 99% of females have reproduced just about a human time. Only 23% of men.
So the point being that
in the olden days, 23% of men had 99% of women. And that isn't necessarily a genetic thing. That's a power thing. That's a success thing, right? You can be a king. You ain't got to be something special, but you're the king. So you fuck all the girls, right? All those other dudes never got pussy. So the reason society's come along and said one man, one woman is for two reasons. One is because it destroys the spirit of a man, like we just discussed, to avoid rebellion. But two, when you have a whole bunch of men who don't get laid, they're dangerous. They're the people who are going to revolt. They're the people who are going to riot. They're the people who are going to commit crime. It's not good for society as a whole. All these men can't get laid. For a long time, we killed them off in wars and shit. But now everyone's living too long, right? So now we all exist. So it's like, all right, everyone needs a partner, and they sit there miserable with their partner and be too busy, too depressed, too sad.
Chad, I said this earlier. Where is this? Is this Dubai? I see,
too self- this,
I see homegirl right here with the hijab on and the rest of her hair wrapped. Dubai, they on some type of rooftop, bunch of tall buildings in the back. He got a diamond watch. It's definitely America or New York. Or London.
Absorbed, too selfish to worry about the bigger picture. So the reason men haven't marched on the street because of Corona is because they're too busy, upset and sad because the woman's being mean to them. That's literally it. It's also the reason they promote depression. Why do they promote mental illness at every corner? Because if you're so busy living inside your head, you don't give a fuck about what they do to you outside of your head. I'm depressed, I'm sad, I'm anxious. I'm depressed, I'm sad, I'm anxious. Poor me, me, me. Self-absorbed. If they self-absorb everybody, then we're not going to rebel. Why do the Western powers also promote diversity? If every single person who's inside of a city doesn't think the same or look the same or have any kind of common ideology, how can they rise up together? How can they all get together and band together against clear injustice? They won't. Well, he looks like that, he thinks this way. He looks like that, he thinks this way. Diversity, feminism, matrimony, all this shit is deliberately designed to stop the men at the bottom realizing they're getting fucked and standing up and doing something. All it is. It's completely a plan. It's been put together and your elites pull it off fantastic. Solid.
Chat, this is Andrew Tate on Rumble, man. How y'all feel about that? Y'all been checking out Rumble? Y'all go follow me on Rumble at Pack 203, man. And subscribe to my goddamn YouTube channel, man.